topic what I'm going to tell is, it is about the calculus, about the introduction of the calculus. The meaning of the calculus is the differentiation of the speeds. Meaning is differentiations of speeds or the distances. So you must be wondering what exactly it is. Now let us take a car which is moving on the road. This is a car. The car will go in 2 minutes 10 kilometers, then in five kilometers 3 kilometers per speed, or in 10 minutes may go 7 kilometers per speed. You must know that. So that means there is a variation. So how to calculate? They have introduced some variations like x, y, and z variables. So let us go into what is this variables. So x means differentiations of the times, y means the differentiation of the distances, and z is also variables. So the whole topic depends upon two variables. Let us take x and y. Forget about the mathematics part. Y means the differentiation of the distances, and z is also variables. So the whole topic depends upon two variables. Let us take x and y. Forget about the mathematics part. In our physical interpretations, we say that x is independent variable. X is independent variable. And y is dependent variable. So if I tell you, even a normal student can understand. X is independent means it is like father, y means son or daughter. So when I take this part, x is, let us say that x is father, y is son. X is working in some industry. And every year he'll get some small increments for his best service. That increment we'll take this as delta x. When father's income increases, son or daughter's income, pocket money also increases. This is what we say. Now, how long the father will give, that is a question. He is independent. Now the son or the daughter, they will also grow. When will the son become independent? When he starts earning. So we can measure the amount of the son's income. Similarly, if I say the daughter, when will the daughter will become independent? When she gets married, that is independence of the girl. So when will the daughter will become independent? When she gets married, that is independence of the girl. So if I want to measure the y, that means the son's income, I can take this as x plus delta x minus of y, or delta y is equals to x plus delta x minus y, means let us take y is equals to x is already there, so minus x, so this and this cancels. Now see, the measurement of the son's income is still depending upon the measurements of the father. Now we have to put the full stop. That means I can introduce the limit parts. Limit is a very important factor. So if I put the delta tends to 0, that means I'm giving a rest to father. Delta x is no more. That means delta y is now active part. So this is for the differential part of the y to differential part of the x. This is called the formula we use. Now you must have got a little doubt, what exactly is the meaning of the limit? Meaning of the limit in physical interpretation also, see, the whole mathematics I take in physical interpretations because the examples will become more in the brain. Limit means, see, suppose our parents are there. Parents will ask us, go and get some articles from the market. So the son or daughter will start answering. They'll tell so many things, say, I need a bag, this thing, that thing. But sometimes the real numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. As L goes to one value, Y starts going to the two value. That means as X decreases, there is a chance for Y to either increase or decrease depending upon the negative, zero or the values. So So this is about the limits part, this is about the differentiation part. I have combined both the topics. This is different topic, this is different. I hope you must have understood a little from what. Is it clear? I'm P.S. Verma. I'm very happy to announce that I am one of the associates of the Tutor Sprite. Yeah, I will be available on Tutor Sprite website.